versus Fnatic.
One rotation that could potentially be there, I've seen it so many times, Earth Spirits just either using the smoke or TPing to the mid lane and just rolling from the trees to get a kill. ICSIS with a bit of a different build on the Beastmaster. He went like a lot of region in this lane. Good roll.
On bottom. EG, they're going to be able to get that first blood. Jabs run down against these tanky heroes. Over towards mid. Do have Jabs hanging around with Moon. Crits there, guarding Arbed. Make sure that Arbed's going to have the space to get the best possible rune. Could look for a kill potential here. They'll try. Straight in onto Moon. Stuns off the mark from Crypt, but they're still able to get the Vortex pulled back. And mass TP's coming in, though, as Moon, he's going to be able to turn with the backup of Jabs and DJ coming in. Arbed, he's out of mana.
He's out of mana.
DJ just off the mark with the stun.
He's having a really good read what's happening.
DJ. Hit the six, he's scouting things out. Ice is going to go for the roar. Arbed jumping over towards Jabs. Can he burst him in time? Pulls him back with Vortex, but he hasn't got the damage. Jabs will be fine. He's able to get the Phoenix Egg off, and Arbed's got a run. Moon will turn his attention over towards Ice. Moon's got the stun. Take down the Beastmaster. Over towards the mid, Arteezy. Should be okay. He still has a Blade Fury and an Omni Slash. Maseros lays down the arena. He's caught blind. Fnatic very prepared for that. Crip. Lining up the stun, he's able to find the connection on the DJ, but the Spike Carapace is out. Moon, he's going to come charging in, sets up with the
good silence.
Arbed, but the silence is down from Fly. Comes out with the Exorcism, Raven and Moon trying to commit onto Arbed, but they can't kill the Storm. As Moon goes down, Raven and DJ, they've got to run crit, hot in the chase, keeping this magnetized going. Huge amounts of damage coming out from the Earth Spirit. DJ will trip him up with the Spike Carapace. They've lost Fly. Can Crit and Arteezy get anything more out of this? Arteezy still
the nice stun.
DJ lines up the two of them with the Impale. Stops Arteezy from being able to get in. Get anything more from this. As you say, you just take the chance of maybe catching him by surprise. Otherwise, you're just not going to get it at all, Arbed. He's going to get caught here by the Blink initiation from Maseros. The follow-up stun from Moon, it's enough damage. They'll do it. They'll burst through Arbed.
Fly, Yule Scepter. Ooh, not in range.
They're going to try and chase for Ice. With the Sunray up on him, Maseros blinks up straight in with the arena. He'll catch another. As they'll lock down Ice. Even using the Supernova, just in case there was going to be able to any sort of counterplay from EG.
Silences, and then you can just use a BKB, Sunray, cannot get interrupted, spin, bottom.
See him, Raven, could he get out of this one? I don't think so. Too much magical damage and nothing to jump over to.
Respecting the Aegis, also not having anything against the Juggernaut, so he feels pretty safe just split pushing. Like, it's being pinged out, like tier 3, Arteezy drops down to healing ward.
Maseros. He tries to get the catch here, he's not going to be able to do so. Blade Fury's out instantly. Crit trying to get in on the front, gets the magnetized down, but the Spike Carapace will keep him held on the high ground. Crit goes down. Rest of EG starts to step back. Yule setup's there. Arbed zips over the arena's down. There's the Omni Sash from Arteezy. And with the Battle Fury, it's cleaving through them all. He takes down Maseros, takes down Jabs up to the high ground. They get the catch on DJ as well. As EG take down 4.
They're going to take the barracks. 19 minutes in, this might be one of the fastest barracks so far in the tournament.
Yeah, very, very carefully.
Even though they have, you know, a lot of physical damage, a lot of stuff that goes through Magic Immunity, Exorcism, Roar, Jug Ulti, you still need to be able to defend yourself.
Bottom. Arbed with a zip in, but the Spike Carapace is there for DJ. DJ turns it around. Arbed getting low, but of course he still has that Aegis anyway. Arbed is still able to zip in. Grab Raven, will go down the once. Fly and Ice are pushing back DJ whilst they leave Crit and Arbed to deal with Raven. As Raven goes down, Ice roars DJ. Mid, Moon, and Maseros. I mean, they're hiding. They're going to try and make a play. They're going to get the jump onto Arteezy, but Fly comes in with the side. Silence onto the two of them. Moon has to put the BKB to try and keep this fight going. Arbed, he's immediately open to the back lines, looks towards Jabs. Jabs is going to burn before he gets any chance to get anything out after the silence. Fly will fall in return, but
there's the Omni.
He's in with a slash, takes down Moon. DJ to fall as well. There's 3 dead on Fnatic. EG, they'll continue with the push on this mid lane as the creep wave will be making its way over. The game is just sped up to a point that Fnatic, they're just struggling to keep up with, unless EG's out alone, but so far EG, they've not been getting caught like that. DDR is available, Arteezy is heading over, he's going to be able to pick it up, they've got to run. As they spotted it out, Fnatic, but they weren't able to stop EG from taking it. Fnatic's got to get out of it. Crit and Arbed are in with the BKBs, they're on top of Raven. Raven, has he got anything to jump to? He hasn't. Raven's down and out. Moon will manage to TP away.
Oh, he pops the egg. Very dead. They're going to get it, so that's 3 kills. They're down too much, like in terms of network, in terms of items. Another good jump.
Immediately onto Moon. Moon's gone. BKB's out from Ice. There's the slash coming in. DJ gets cut down. Two down yet again. Masteros is not getting out of this one as EG surround him. Triple kill.
This might be it, though.
Ice.
EG is called.
EG's called. I mean, it's absolutely over this one as EG. I mean, they couldn't.
Here we have it. Jabs on the techies. Let's see what Fnatic's got up their sleeves.
Now mid lane, the Spirits. Moon on the Ember versus
bottom
Arbin
lane.
On the Void.
They're going to go on him. Silence from techies.
There we go.
Won't quite get it there on the next hit. So Masteros will be fine. Masteros, got any regen coming out over towards the bottom. Jabs tries to jump in. He's not going to be able to get the kill. Ends up getting taken down as Fly turns towards him. DJ trying to escape. Chasing on, the Splinter
One
Blast connects,
hit.
Crit, he's got the kill, takes out the two of them.
Nicely done. Abed has double damage on the mid lane, they might try to go for him.
Good attempt with the Remnant there, Abed, but couldn't quite find the angle between the creep waves coming in.
A lot of time wasted by techies. He's the level 3 there, having a trial in, there's the blast off.
Well, this time, that will certainly do it. Level 2 blast off, Jabs has the damage. See top, they're going to be able to get the angle. Ice sits up with a swashbuckle, crit. Tries to get in on this, but they're turning things around. Black Holes dropped down from Masteros. The follow-up damage from Jabs. Bottom lane. Abed. Make a play onto Raven with the backup of Ice.
Oh, that's nicely done.
See if they can get him the second time round. Jabs watching from the side, but the Rolling Thunder out from Ice. Should be able to find the line over towards Jabs as well. They went up the damage to take down Raven. Jump forward. On towards the Void Spirit, Jabs trying to go for the kill. He's got to be careful. One more jump from Arbeb will catch him. Jabs, he's hiding in with the Dissimilate. Jabs, he's gone. Interrupt the farming of this Ember Spirit.
Now we're not talking about techies. How's the most important hero in this game doing? Moon will be able to kill Pangolier. I think there were a couple of mines there as well.
Yeah, just gets him with the chains and just commits with the Remnants, blows him up. He's not of course yet able to start burning into the hood mid lane. Gonna have the setup. Ice buying back to get involved in this fight. Masteros just down
black
his ground,
hole,
pops
no
the black
off.
Blast off is there from Jabs, but Masteros will get taken down underneath the tower. Jabs beaten out as well by Arbed and EG. They're gonna look to try and chase for more. Ice Rolling Thunder, good to go. All the shards block him off. DJ's able to make sure that the space is there for Moon to get out without Ice getting the catch on him. Moon comes back in with the slide of fist.
Buyback
That's
from
gonna
crit.
Be a buyback from Crit. As the setup's here, Arteezy.
Arrow.
Has he got the timing? He does. The sleep setup into the Remnant, into the arrow. They lock down Moon. And now DJ will also fall as Ice is protected by the cold embrace of Fly.
But I guess he just wants to be able to, you know, tank up all the damage
mid
lane.
I mean, this is, as you say, the punishment that will be there for playing with that buyback in that last fight. He gets taken down again, Ice. And
some more pressure on the mid lane. They also don't have too much tower damage. If there's
Fly.
No Necro unit, if there's no Eidolon's crit, where is he? Not saving his body, Fly.
He's completely alone here, Fly is Fnatic. See mid, Ice. He's trying to keep the pressure off the tier 1 tower. Bottom lane, EG. They're ready to jump in and look for Jabs. As Arbed, he's found him. Set up with the Orchid into the Remnant. He's going to have the burst to take down Jabs. DJ unable to save him. Towards mid, Ice. He's going to try and lead things in onto Raven. Raven, he's got the reincarnation.
Good bounces.
So if they can do it a second time. Crit's coming over the arrow. Oh, it's perfectly timed. He manages to land it. Over towards the side. Fly's going to control Masteros with the curse to make sure that there's no black hole to threaten the rest of EG. The backup, try and reset and get back in with the invis. Over
black
towards
hole.
The mid lane, Masteros, he'll just drop it straight up. Onto Ice. They'll get the kill, but now they've got to be cautious as Moon is very low on the mana. Into the Orchid, he's silenced and held in place. Moon, he's going to die for this effort. They may have got Ice, but it's a black hole down and also their mid laner down. Doesn't want to stick around too long with the Axe. That stats. Jabs is tanky enough to live through the damage of the illusions. Ice, he's looking for the cleanup. He's going in. He's going towards the fountain. Oh, yeah, he's going to start TPing out. Bit of a wild move there. You know, one of the reasons why we love to see Ice.
Nagasaren about to have a hard finish, so that's going to tank her up quite a bit.
They're trying to get the catch on Arteezy. See if they can do it. They've got to get through the Aegis. The rest of EG making their way over. Song's available, curses available. Fnatic's going to be very careful about how they commit for the second fight. Pop of the mirror image, Arteezy starting to step away over towards the back line. Zarbet jumps over towards Jazz, pulls him back with the Remnant, takes him out. Going to be able to keep Arteezy safe here with the Cold Embrace. BKB's out from Moon, Ice coming back across. The song comes to an end. Darts Easy continuing to retreat, and he's away. They can't chase any further as Easy's going to push the back past Ross. We're going to look at Arbor, but the curse fly puts a stop to the black hole. Arrow out onto Raven, over to the side. The silence and the ensnare catching Moon. Moon will go down. DJ and Raven, they're trying to find Ice. Malefice out into crit. They bring down the Mirada. Artesian Abed, they're ready to swing back in, though. Artesian's picked up the heart. He's healing back up. They've got a run, Fnatic. They're only down to Raven and DJ. Raven, he'll fall the once.
That's his first life.
Can DJ do anything to save him? He can't. The Orchid out again from Artesian, silencing DJ. He has to run. He's got to leave Raven, as DJ cannot fight this.
Nice dodge by Abed.
Abed takes down DJ. TP over from Jabs. Jabs, can he do anything to help him? There's going to be a buyback coming out. But Abed's cleaned up the double kill. Over towards Jabs. DJ's brought back for this, but he knows he cannot TP in here. He can do nothing to help Jabs as EG.
Oh, that was such a nice done by EG. Pretty much a perfect timing.
As EG still bringing in this, this mid lane. Ooh, there we go. There, we finally got one.
Oh, look at that gold.
We finally got a 1,200 gold.
Okay.
That's what it's all about. That is literally the reason why Jabs is playing tech.
Pop by Moon.
Yeah, sort of has to there. Worried about the follow-up that could be coming out if he did get hit.
So Arteezy, he's coming in with a setup. He's managed
another arrow is ready.
See if they've got the setup. They do, DJ. They get caught out. Ice coming in the points. Okay, Jabs, he's able to get Abed. Abed has been blown up. So if EG want to keep fighting on without their Void Spirit, I've got to be careful around this area. They're going to be a little bit spooked after losing Abed like that. Waves on their course to get to these back lines. Maybe try and catch Fly before Fly's able to interrupt the team fight with the curse. They're going in on Arteezy in the mid. On the side, Moon's committed with the BKB, trying to keep the backliners of EG away. And now,
the, curse?
The black hole is coming
it's
in.
Coming.
Out Fly, he's in position. He's able to curse Maseros, put the black hole to an end. Maseros will go down, and Arteezy will be able to back up. He may even be able to get back in. Turns with the root onto Raven. On the side, DJ trying to watch, but he's been found. Arbet jumps over, finds DJ in the trees, takes him down. Raven will be able to slam down crit. Buyback from the two of them here. It's both Maseros and DJ want to get back in on this.
Abed still has that Arcane rune running.
I mean, Moon.
Good setup.
His BKB still on cooldown for 35 seconds. They're in onto Moon. Moon in trouble. DJ coming over with the snowball. Can he save him? Moon goes down. Jump forward with the blast off. Arteezy and Ice both low. And they're trapped right
drop.
By Raven. Raven, he's able to take down Arteezy. Turns towards Ice as well. As the buybacks pay off, Fnatic, they'll be able to take the team fight. And, is he going to get. He's got them.
He's silenced again, but look at the mines. It's being pinged out. Where's the arrow? Here it comes.
Oh!
Does not dodge
he
it.
He doesn't. Comes out of the slide, gets hit by the arrow, taken out by the illusion. That's Moon dead for 80 seconds.
Full to not like get his E on this proc, but he's not the full HP. That's the Aegis regeneration. Arrow.
I connect. Ice, he's in. That's DJ down. No buyback on DJ. He's out for 90 seconds. EG now with a number advantage. Jump forward from Moon. Tries to get the catch, won't find it.
I hope you guys, you know, went to the bathroom, have enough water and everything, but be sure to get some snacks, because this one seems to be that's going to last forever.
Oh, man, we have this attempt on Arteezy. We actually have the refresher pop by Moon so we can get in. He's going to be able to find the black hole follow. Maseros, he gets the lowest head on the two of them, but Fly comes in with a curse, holds down Moon.
He's stuck.
Arteezy is still trapped in between the four of them. He's able to put the mirror image. He will get out of there as Fly's able to set up the turnaround. They take out both of them, both Moon and Jabs going down. Jabs will buy back. So they can take down Raven a second time. They burn through the reincarnate. Arteezy, Arbin, and crits around him. As that's going to be it's going to be Raven out. He's out for 100. He has no buyback. He's always going to have the chance to interrupt things. This time, not necessarily canceling the black hole, but making sure that Fnatic just couldn't find any follow-up after it came to an end. And Arteezy able to live. They take top racks, mid racks. They'll sweep over towards bottom. Still 40 seconds until Raven's back in. Bottom's a little spookier with the mines out.
They should be able to clean that up. They still have a gem. Void Spirit once again holding it. Next Roche is up. She's Aegis plus a refresher. Like they want to get refresher in this one. I would say much more value, especially for Winter Wyvern's second curse possibly, or just, you know, have the BKBs another song. But I feel like Fly should be the one getting it. I don't think he hit anyone once. EG trying to go in, possibly, you know, end the game, but with the techies, you never know.
Got to be careful. Raven jumping in. Sign has been dropped on the mines around these two tier fours. Be careful how hard they're pushing. Arteezy feeling safe though with the Aegis. He's going to try and trade into Raven. Raven hitting back with the Swift Link pretty fast and hard, but Arteezy's got a lot of armor. There's the jump again. Moonlight Shadow, EG setting up behind Arteezy. Raven has to be careful how far he commits. Does not have buyback gold. Now he's going to get jumped. So they can take him down the one side. Size him with a follow-up Rolling Thunder. They'll try and force Raven off to the side. DJ has been caught on the front of it all. He will get the snowball off. And they're going to lose DJ almost certainly as the snowball will come to an end. No, he's got the blink. DJ actually able to blink back to the fountain.
Going for the buildings.
Raven is looking for a second round as he gets back over towards Arteezy. But Arteezy, the damage with this Bloodthorn and the illusion.
First life. Arrow.
Takes him down. The arrow won't connect. Raven able to start backing off, but EG, they're doing the damage to Tier 4. So Arteezy continues to push.
That's the first Tier 4 tower down. They can keep pushing, still Aegis on Arteezy.
It's Raven. He's trying to get in. They do have those two black holes if Masteros can find them. He's got to go for something completely incredible. As he's down 27k already, the jumps have been made on the back lines. Arteezy's going to pop the song. Heads over to Moon with the Abyssal. Moon, he's got to get out. The BKB's going to short come to an end. Crit's able to find the time of the arrow. Hits in Moon.
There's
he's
the
dead.
Bashes.
He's out and he's down.
Available.
See if he uses it. Get back in Masteros. He's going to go for the first black hole. On the two of them, but the curse fly puts a stop to it. Again, just stopping Masteros in his tracks. And Masteros does not have buyback. The Enigma's out for 100 seconds. They've caught Moon outside of the base. Moon's gone.
I believe that's it. Nice play from Fly. He had the two Winter's Curses. That's the third one. He actually used the refresher just to set things up.
I mean, it's just too much for them. There's the, well, the mines come out.
He kills Ice, but
these are
old mines. Like, they don't have anything else prepared.
As on to the side, Raven trying desperately to defend. DJ, buy him a little bit of safety inside the snowball. Raven attempting to run. Raven, he's out and down. No buyback on him. GG is cool. As with that EG, they'll secure themselves both wins here in this series, 2-0 against Fnatic.
Big W for EG, big W for Dota community, you know, watching techies lose.